the pride of the panther as he glows in splendor and grace, toppling obstacles placed in the way of the progression of his race. Can you see the pride in the panther as she nurtures her young all alone? The seed must grow regardless of the fact that it's planted in stone. Can't you see the pride in the panthers as they unify as one? The flower blooms with brilliance and outshines the rays of the sun. Outshines like the sun, shines out like the sun, shines bright like the sun, brings light like the sun.
P is for power, the A for action, the NT because now is the time to get it done. See, the H is for heart and the E for effect. The all hold it down at the end for respect. Who am I, a panther? Who am I, a panther? What I got, I got soul. What I got, I got love. What I got, I got pride. What I wanna be free. Raise your hands in the air if you feel like me. Who am I, a panther? Who am I, a panther? What I got, I got soul. What I got, I got love. What I got, I got pride. What I wanna be free. Raise your hands in the air if you feel like me.
This song is dedicated to all those who live and die for the struggle. Panthers, children of the Panthers, and all those who strive for free minds, free souls, free bodies, and freedom, and love. Love. Love is the engine to the revolution.
What's your name?
Cameron.
Say it loud.
Cameron!
Cameron, you got honor roll, Cameron?
Yes.
You do?
Yes. I got honor roll.
You got honor roll too?
Yes.
You got honor roll too? Everybody in the squad got honor roll, huh?
Yes, sir.
The whole squad got honor roll. You got honor roll?
That girl.
I know you ain't got honor roll. No, we got to see your report card, bro. You got to see your report card.
Honor roll?
Malik don't have honor roll, right? Hold up.
I'm
going
to give you it.
Nah, bro, you gotta get honor roll next time, son.
See, I notice in everything that you have said that it appears to me that your concept of socialism is not a doctrinaire one. The charge that you are all communists or that you are all Maoists, it seems to me that what you say adds up to the fact that you're approaching the idea of socialism from a pragmatic standpoint, in the view of this situation racially, economically, and in its world position. Would that be correct, and could you expand on it?
Yes, but not only that. I think that it's not so much as being doctrinaire. We're not doctrinaire, because we're more interested in really dealing with the social forces than adhering to some so-called Marxist-Leninist principle, which might not be Marxist-Leninist after all, because Marx himself said that one thing that I'm not a Marxist. And what he meant, that he wasn't going to follow any doctrinaire thing. He was going to use the science of materialism in a creative fashion, and that makes the true Marxist-Leninist, you see. But what is really happening is that we've carried Marxist-Leninism to a higher level. We say that the party, the Black Panther Party, is the greatest Marxist-Leninist of all times, and we're not bragging when we say that, but we realize that history has bestowed upon us an obligation, and that is to take the science and take the philosophy of Marx to its final goal, and that is to create a world that has an absence of statehood. And this is why, in the first of my speech or my talk with you, I emphasize the fact that we're no longer revolutionary nationalists, that we don't believe what's commonly called nationhood for America, you see. We believe that America now must subscribe to strict internationalism, because while these other revolutionary countries are and who are Marxist-Leninists are revolutionary nationalists in the respect that they are fighting for autonomy and they're fighting for independence and nationhood. We support that because they have to do that in order to defend themselves against the international bourgeoisie, the international aggressor. We realize that if America didn't support every fascist and bourgeois government in the world, that government couldn't exist and the people would win their revolution immediately. So what I'm saying is that while it might sound in contradiction, it's only paradoxical that when I say that blacks, we should ask the black people exactly what direction we want to go, we also are going to explain some things to them, and that is that whatever way we go, that white America can no longer remain a nation. And taking this under consideration, I'm saying that once America stopped relating to this nationalism, it won't be necessary for any other country in the world to relate to nationalism. So developing these kind of concepts, we think that we've taken Marxist-Leninism to even a higher level than it's ever been in history, because history has not yet created the communist world. It's only created the socialist world that is also based upon statehood. So the next stage would be the communist world, where statehood no longer exists. And we will take the banner of the people's struggle, the black and the red banner, to the final victory.
Is there anything else you would like to say to us, Huey?
I would like to say power to the people, because without the people, there will be no victory. And the people are responsible for historical developments, and they're responsible for the course that history takes. And no matter what kind of weapon the oppressor has, that we know that one new weapon doesn't win the war, but the people always win. And the people are the real heroes, and without this knowledge, we don't have even the rudimentary knowledge.
Thank you very much.